Hi. Okay, today we're going to make some little storage bottles. Now, I saw this on a couple of different YouTube channels, and I'm sorry, I don't remember who they were. It was late night surfing because I couldn't sleep. But I do remember one guy was recommending to use silicone, and another guy was recommending to use super glue. So my first two tries were the super glue. Not airtight. Silicone, like you use for your bathtub. Airtight, but it has so much flex in this joint here that I'm worried that if you tightened it tight enough to make sure no water could get in through the cap, that you might wind up ripping the silicone loose. So I'm not going to go with that either. Then I went on to try a bunch of other things. This is what the British call PVA glue, I believe. It's not much different than white carpenter's glue. It says it bonds anything to anything. Again, not watertight. I think this stuff, it shrinks too much as it dries, so that's why that one was a failure. I tried the ABS cement you use for putting together the plastic drain pipes in your house, the plumbing. That one gave an airtight seal. Took forever to dry. It was messy. And it left glue running in the bottom of the little container, so I'm not going to recommend that either. I tried two-part epoxy, the quick-setting stuff. Again, not watertight seal. Well, then I had some of the good two-part epoxy, the slow setting stuff. I thought maybe that dried too quick to flow into all the cracks and crevices and give an airtight seal. Not quite airtight. There's a little blister right there that allows air out, so it'll allow water in. Then I tried flexible plastic adhesive, supposed to be waterproof. That one gave an airtight seal. Gave an ugly seal, but airtight. I tried Gorilla Glue. That one gave an airtight seal. But again, it left a lot of glue in the bottom of the container, so I'm not going to recommend that one either. I tried model airplane cement. That one worked. I should say it didn't work the first try. It left a gap on the a visible gap, but due to the nature of this glue, it was very easy to take it and fill that gap afterwards. So I'm going to say that one is worth recommending. And the last one that I tried was the hot glue gun. And that one worked. So that's the three choices that I'll recommend. Model airplane cement, flexible plastic household cement, and the hot glue gun. Now to make these, you need two bottles. This is just a standard PET PET plastic water bottle. Pop bottles work. Some of these are pop bottles. Some of them are water bottles. Some of them are the sparkling water bottles. And you need either two of them or you need one plus a cap. Now the first thing you need to do is to cut through about a quarter of an inch below the lip on the bottle. And I just did that with the serrated blade of my Leatherman. Found that the bottles for sparkling water or pop bottles are thicker and therefore easier to cut with the knife blade and make a decent cut. The cheap plastic water bottles you could cut just with the scissors. Now you need to clean this up a wee bit. And I like to cut that ring off of there just to get it out of the way. Test fit. Yes, it will go on. You want to apply a good amount of glue on the outside of the top of this. And a good amount of glue, almost like you were applying caulking, so you fill up a 45 degree that edge is filled at 45 degrees. I know lots of this is gonna squeeze out and be wasted, but otherwise you won't get an airtight seal. Definitely won't get a spastic proof seal. Okay, so we'll leave that dry, and then with the hot glue gun, it should be hot by now, yes. I'm going to fill that little shelf up at 45 degrees. pop a cap on and let it cool without getting your fingers in it. Now, if you decide after the fact to clean this up, be very careful and use a very sharp knife going down parallel to the black cap, because you don't want to accidentally pull the glue out. The other thing you could do is just pinch it up on the sides. But I don't really recommend that, especially not barehanded, if you're not a semi-professional welder. So there's our two of the three choices for the glue, and of course this, you know, the rubber cement you use. Plastics make you use exactly the same as the model airplane glue. Now, these could find use in your cook kit as spice jars, in your first aid kit as pill bottles, in your tackle box for hooks, or weights, in your toolbox for little screws. Interesting little bottles, easy to do, even with kids as young as beavers, though you're going to need to supervise the hot glue gun. These little hot glue guns don't quite get hot enough stay liquid long enough to apply the cap. Thank you for watching.